Hello and welcome to the End of Realms gameplay video. Our adventure starts in the Wastes, the remotest and probably most dangerous region of the known world. The Wastes are inhabited by monsters such as this Wraith. We can defeat the Wraith by using our combat skills. Most of our skills are capable of dealing damage. There are three types of damage in the End of Realms: fortitude, defense, and willpower. And conversely, our character and our enemies also have three stats each: fortitude, defense, and willpower. In order to win in combat, we have to deplete one of the enemy stats to zero. However, if our enemy depletes one of our stats before that, we lose and we are forced to retreat. We've used magic and beaten the Wraith on willpower. Now let's see the first bit of tutorial dialogue. This guy over here is Bartholo. He is the last, best, and only friend of our main character. Together they are scouring the Wastes looking for magical items. At various points in the game we can have others follow or accompany us, but we only ever control the main character. Right now we have to choose where to go next. This is basically just clicking one of the two available location buttons. We pick stone rings and look! We found a sword! Now we have to equip it by entering the equipment screen and dragging the sword into the weapon slot. Done. Life goes on. We choose another location. This time let's go with Ruined Keep. And bam! We found a ring. Sadly the ring isn't magic, just valuable. There is a special screen that houses valuable and miscellaneous items. We are in the Wastes looking for ancient magics, not gold and silver. As such, we can only carry 5 valuable items at a time. Alright, let's speed this up. At a certain point in the tutorial, we learn new skills. Doom and Furor. Our skill tab becomes available and we have to slot in the newly learned skills. There are 10 combat skill slots. At the very start of the game, only 4 of them are filled, but that is only due to the fact that we do not start with a sufficient amount of skills. Throughout the game, all 10 slots have to remain filled. Let's drag in some Furors. We will go with the Fortitude route. Doom is just about as good, but the combination of Doom and Furor doesn't make much sense because you only have to deplete one of the enemy stats in combat, not two, and Doom deals willpower damage. Our protagonist and his friend eventually find the lair of a lich. They think to destroy the creature and claim its treasure, but things don't go down too well for them. In the ensuing combat, Bartholo is hit by a bolt of dark magic and dies. At a very steep price, our character gets hold of Eternus the Timeless, a powerful magic sword. He is heartbroken and at this point in time he only wishes to leave the Wastes behind. We obtain our first quest. We have to cross the cursed pass and make our way back to safety. With the help of Eternus, this is an easy feat. We soon leave behind the gloomy scenery of the Waste, and our character eventually finds himself in an inn. The final stage of the tutorial is barter. Do you remember the ruby ring we found towards the beginning of this tutorial? Our hero means to trade it for mead and drink away his sorrows. In order to make a trade, we drag the ring on our side of the table, and the flagon of mead on the merchant's side. If our side is worth at least as much as the merchant's, we can conclude the trade by pressing the button in the middle. Once this is done, we are through with the tutorial. Chapter 1 takes place sometime after Bartholo's death. By then, our hero is known as a great adventurer and the owner of a superbly powerful magic sword. Does his newfound fame serve him well? Was the trade worth it? What does End of Realms look like outside of the Wastes? If you want to find out, you'll have to play the game. I hope this video was somewhat informative and entertaining. Thank you for watching.